There are quite a few cases that we want to lengthen an object without changing its size in general. This can be achieved if we use the stretch tool. The stretch tool can be found either in the Modify menu or in the Modify panel of the Home ribbon. In the first example, the distance between the two circle centers is 20 centimeters. However, I realized after having created them that the distance is wrong. The centers should have been 25 centimeters apart. To correct that, I will activate the stretch tool. A message prompts me to select the objects I wish to stretch. I will select the parts I want and press Enter. Then, I need to specify the base point. I will set the base point to the center of the circle and proceed to move the cursor to the right. However, as you can see, the shape isn't being stretched, it is being moved instead. This happened because the only way to perform stretch is to select the object using the crossing method. If I select them by clicking on them one by one, or by using the window method, as I did, I will only move the objects. So I will press Escape and activate the stretch tool again. This time, I will select the objects using the crossing method, set the base point to the center of the circle again, and move the cursor to the right. Notice that now the shape is stretching. All that is left is to define the extra length, so I will type the number 5 and press Enter. The command deactivates automatically and the result is now correct. At this point, I should mention that when you wish to stretch an object, the extent of the crossing window plays a major role on what part of the shape will be stretched. To get a clearer picture of what I mean, I want you to take a look on the following picture to understand the different results according to the extent of the selection. As you can see, the part of the shape that is being stretched depends on the junctions that are included in the selection. Based on what we have already learned about the stretch tool, let's move on to another example. In this floor plan, there are two windows. Imagine that I want to stretch the vertical window so it becomes 2 meters long. To do that, I will activate the stretch tool again. I will select the upper side of the window and with the Shift key pressed, I will remove the walls from the selection. Then, I will set the base point to the upper right corner, move my cursor upward, and type the number 1. As you can see, as soon as I pressed Enter, the window became 2 meters, but the walls remained as they were. I will click on the Undo icon from the Quick Access toolbar to return to the point where the window was not stretched yet. Now I will repeat the procedure, but this time I will let the walls be part of the selection. Setting the same base point again, I will move my cursor upward, type the number 1, and press Enter. Notice that now the walls have shrunk in proportion to the stretch of the window.